and welcome to Throwback Thursday. If you're new to my channel, this is a little series that I did all throughout 2021 where I reached back into my stash for older retired papers and I made something new and fun with them. Today, I'm reaching back to an old design that I made, I think in 2020, maybe 2019. Desk calendars, monthly desk calendars. I think I'm going to do this as a little series throughout 2022, but this year I'm going to be using Graphic 45's Time to Flourish. They have just reissued this, and I broke my rule of no new paper for the first month of the year because this was always one of my favorite collections, and I went ahead and grabbed it, and I put together this really fun easel-style desk calendar, and we're going to put this together in the tutorial that follows, so hang around. And I'll just go ahead and get it out of the way. I'm recovering from a little head cold. It is not COVID. You can still get a cold or the flu and it not be COVID, just so you know. So my voice is a little messed up, but I'm feeling great. Got my energy back and I wanted to pop in here and share a fun idea for January. I splurged and I purchased Graphic 45's Deluxe Collector Edition of Time to Flourish. I got the 8x8 and the 12x12. And it's a little challenging to work in with because even with having both of those, I'm finding it hard to get enough paper to do what I want to do. But I got this great idea for making desk calendars for each month of the year just to kind of add a little bright spot of color. I did this a couple years back with Authentique papers, and it was wildly successful, so I've kind of changed the design up a little bit, and I'm going to do it again. So the first thing I want you to do is take two sheets of chocolate brown cardstock, and I want you to trim them to 6 inches wide by, how did I do that, 8.5. And then I join them together with a 1/4 inch of score tape. And you can see here's the little joint. And the way I do that is I put my score tape on the exact edge of the paper. And then I can line my other sheet of paper up with that and I get a nice straight union. Then I put this on my scoring tool. And I realize I'm going kind of fast here today, but it's because my voice won't hold out for that long. I scored at 3, I scored at 6, I scored at 6.25. Then I folded. And once I folded, I scored at 7, and this creates our little pocket. So this is what the inside looks like. And I've lined this with a light blue cardstock I had in my stash. So this is 5.75 by, hold on. Everything's 1/4 inch smaller than the base, by 2.75. And same up here, 5.75 by 2.75. And then my liner papers are 5.5 by 2.5. So then I've just cut up some of the 8x8 paper to line here. This is from the 12x12. And then this is going to be our base. So on the back, flip it over, and you're going to take a piece of the same piece of that blue, same blue cardstock, and you're going to cut it to 6.25 by 7.75, and you score 1/2 inch top and bottom, 1/2 inch on the right-hand side. And this is gonna form a little folio pocket on the bottom side of the card, which is a little bit different than the way I did it with the Authentique, but I kind of like the way this works. It makes the inside of the card a little less bulky. So I'm just gonna turn this so that I know, okay. So this fold goes on the left-hand side on the back, and then just lay this down. And this does two things. It creates this great little folio pocket, but it also hides where we joined our paper together. So it's kind of a sneaky trick. And we all need some of those in our pocket. So this is gonna be like this. And then to go in that, I took some more of my blue paper. I cut out the January ledger page from the 12x12, matted it on a slightly larger piece of brown, And then I matted that whole thing on a 6 1/4 by, I guess this ended up being 10 3/8. And then I took another piece, cut it to the same 6 1/4. And this was just a piece I had on my desk. It's 4 3/4. I scored a 1/2 inch flap. So we're gonna make a little flap on this folio. So this is a great place to keep pictures, you know, but this is gonna slip right into this pocket. If I did it right. Oh, did I do it backwards? Oh, for heaven's sake. All right, so it's gonna go on this side. So that works too. All right, and it's gonna stick out like this. All right, then for this pocket, I just wanna show you very quickly, I cut a couple of little gussets. These are just 1 inch wide by the depth of the pocket. So what did I say, 2 3/4 inches? And then you fold them in half, and then you can get a lot in that pocket. So here's our basic easel card base. Now, I already completed the cover. And this is another 6 by 6 inch piece of the brown cardstock. This is a 5 3/4 by 5 3/4. Of the blue, then a little piece of white, a narrow piece of brown, and then I stitched. I'll give you the dimensions of the patterned paper. 5 1/4 inch square from the 12 by 12. And it doesn't really matter. I think I took it from the upper left-hand corner because I can see that cardinal there. And then on the 12 by 12 page, you've got a bunch of cut-aparts, and in there is this 4 by 4 cardinal, which happens to be exactly the right size to fit in this Rene Bouquet's snowflake frame. And I heat embossed this with Wow Diamond White embossing powder. Then I backed it with a piece of clear cardstock. And you can see I put 3 layers of foam tape, and then I adhered my image to the back to create my shaker box. And before I adhered the image, I filled it with this little shaker mix. I've got some little snowmen, some little white buttons, there's little snowflakes in there. And if you go to Buttons Galore, they've got a ton of really great shaker elements that you can, I like to mix and match and then make my own custom mixes. Then I wrapped this panel before I glued my shaker box down. I wrapped this panel with this pretty piece of white satin with a silver metallic edge, tied a bow, and then added a flower here. So this is gonna go right here on the front of the card. So all I have to do now is decorate my blank places and fill in my folio. So I'm gonna work on that. And when I get it done, I'll come back and show you so that my voice doesn't give out on me. So don't go away. Okay, guys, here it is all finished up. Thanks for letting me take that break to rest my voice. I love the way this turned out. This is pretty. So here's our shaker box. And I will show you, I put a little flower underneath it because I wanted to support this very delicate, beautiful board. So, and this is the pine branches from Rene Bouquet's. And then I added this cute little snow boy. This is also a Rene Bouquet's printed beautiful board. And then down here, I just put the chipboard piece, a couple more flowers, a last little snippet of ribbon I had. And here's our pullout folio on the side. And this turned out really cute. Again, this is 6 1/4. And I just pieced together some pieces to make this little trifold. The insides are 6, and I want to say they're 4 3/4, but let me just double check myself. Yep, 6 by 4 3/4. And you can see I had to paper piece because, as I said before, you don't really get enough to do more than about one of these calendars. I use pretty much every little scrap. And this is just like a little photo mat place, but down here I made a pocket. So for some of the little cut aparts from the 8x8, and this is just a scrap that I scored half inch, and then I made a gusset to go on the bottom. And these little guys, wait a minute, those don't go there. This little tag and these little images go there. And then this folds up. I use the stamps to make a pocket. And then these are just little mini folios. You can do little notes in there, little photos on the back. Here's the little January calendar. It's just blank on the inside, but a great place to add photos. You could line that with white and put in birthdays or special dates or whatever if you wanted to. So that is this. I got something loose in there. Hold on. Okay, this little guy. All right, there we go. And then this just goes in the side pocket that's on the left this time. And I didn't line the back of this with anything because really it's not seen. I just left it the plain blue cardstock. And then that will slide in there nicely. So this opens up. Here's how I decorated the top. I just took the sticker and matted it, put it up here. The little tag down here. And then in this inner pocket, I just created a little, a little wet glue there. Matted this and put the little tag from the 8x8 behind it as a pull tab, and then took this little 4x4 and pieced together a little folio. So this is a great way to do birthday cards. I think this is just a really fun way to do birthday cards. And how fun would it be to put photos of the birthday boy or girl from when they were, the year they were born, like their graduation, first day of school, those sorts of things. It'd be a really fun and personal gift. So that's my idea for using Graphic 45's Time to Flourish, the collector's edition. It's kind of a throwback because I did these little desk calendars before and kind of working with something new. This really is a beautiful collection. It was always one of my favorites. But that's it for me, Kathy Clement, Kathy by Design. If you enjoyed this, please give the video a like because it helps other, YouTube will send it out to other scrappers out there and help my channel grow. We can all have more fun together. And if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and subscribe and then click the bell and you'll be notified every time I do a new video. I'm going to try, once I catch up from the holidays, I'm going to try to do 2 a week. So something maybe on Tuesdays and something maybe on Thursdays if time allows. All right, guys, go get your craft on. Bye.